Hello friends, good morning and welcome. So yesterday we have finished pollution of air as well as water. Now in today's video lecture, we are going to discuss some more issues related to environment. In that, the first is waste and their effects. So waste, we are all familiar with this term waste. So if you want to simply define the waste, you can define in the way that the things that are of no use, we call generally the things that are waste. Okay, so generally which things we call waste? The things which we cannot use, or the things that remain after some use, that are known as waste. So waste may be in the form of solid, in the form of liquid, and there are two separate strategies for their management. Okay. As far as solid waste is concerned, so solid waste refers to everything that goes out into trash. Okay. So as I told you earlier, that the things which are remains after use, or the things that are of no use, we call them as waste. Especially in case of solid waste, it refers to everything that goes out into trash. It comprises municipal solid waste, and it contains waste collected from home, as well as waste generated from office, then waste that is generated at stores, then waste collected from schools as well as hospitals, etc. And these waste are collected by municipal corporation and get disposed. Okay, so all solid waste cannot be completely burned. All solid waste cannot be completely burned. Open dumps serve as the breeding ground for rats and flies. So, in case of the solid waste, it is very tedious to treat that solid waste. Okay. If that solid waste is not treated properly, it creates various problems. It causes pollution of soil as well as pollution of water. So, the waste generated in our home as well as some offices or some stores, it gets collected by municipal corporation. Okay. And after collecting that waste, it gets dumped at specific site. After dumping at the specific site, that waste gets deteriorated. Okay. If that waste is not treated properly, it turns into anaerobic degradation, thereby it causes oil spill as well as some pollutants. They get leached from that waste into soil stream, as well as they also leach into water stream, thereby causing soil as well as water pollution. So waste management, especially in case of solid waste, is a big concern in most of the countries, including our country, and this is the burning issue. And there are several strategies that are used for solid waste management, but still it is not applied at a proper level, and the 10% solution for this problem is not discussed or does not get invented. Okay. So generally, as I told you before, that the waste after collecting, it get dumped at dumping sites or dumping ground, and it turns anaerobically, or it turns at anaerobic degradation, where it causes the leaching of pollutants from that waste, and it causes pollution of soil as well as pollution of water. Besides that, it creates additional sites for breeding site. It creates additional breeding site for vectors like mosquitoes, and it leads to a spread of vector-borne diseases. Okay, so there are several drawbacks of normal dumping. If it is not treated, it creates lots of problems, and the sites where that waste get dumped, we call that sites at sanitary landfills, and these are the substitute for open burning dumps. And in these, the waste are dumped and depressed or trenched and converted with the So this is one of the method of treating that solid waste. In that, you can see the waste is dumped and it is covered by a thin layer of dirt. After covering, the degradation of that waste start, and the biodegradable portion will get easily degraded by microbes. So among the garbage, especially in metros, has increased so much that these cities are getting clean too. So it is really a big concern in metropolitan cities or in metro cities. The population is increasing day by day, and as the population is increasing day by day, the accumulation of waste is also increasing day by day. Okay. So large scale accumulation of waste in metro cities is a big concern and it is a big challenge to manage that waste. Since it needs collection, it needs proper disposal, and it requires additional manpower as well as money, and it is really a big concern. Okay. So in case of solid waste, it is classified into three categories. First is biodegradable, then second is non-biodegradable, and third is recyclable. So in case of biodegradable waste, it is easily degradable. Why we call that waste biodegradable? Because it can easily get degraded by the action of microbes, and there are several microbes like bacteria, fungi. They degrade that waste, and that category of microbes they are known as decomposers. And all that decomposer category microbes, they degrade that waste. And in this category, it includes vegetable waste as well as fruit waste. Okay. And biodegradable waste has a privilege and advantage that we can, if that biodegradable waste is properly collected and properly treated, so we can develop manure from that biodegradable waste, and that manure can be used as a fertilizer in the gardens as well as agricultural fields. And that preparation of manure is popularly known as composting. So that biodegradable waste we can treat both aerobically as well as anaerobically. In case of aerobic degradation, that process of aerobic degradation is popularly known as composting, while in case of anaerobic degradation we can generate gas that we call as biogas from that biodegradable waste, and the process is purely carried out in aerobic conditions. So these are all details regarding biodegradable waste. In case of a non-biodegradable waste, it comprises plastic packets or plastic plates, then polythene bags and polystyrene material. Okay. So these are non-biodegradable. Okay. These are highly resist to biodegradable mechanisms, and the microbes, they don't have machinery to degrade these kind of waste. And as these are non-biodegradable, they resist for a longer time in the environment, and it creates severe problems. And you know, plastic waste, there is a big concern in our country as well as other countries, and use of plastic is banned, especially carry bags and some polythene bags. They get banned before several days ago, and it creates various problems. They don't get degraded easily, and they persist for longer time. And due to their persistence, it creates several problems. It causes pollution of soil, it causes pollution of water. Besides that, it clogs drainage as well as it creates hurdles to animals. Okay, so plastic waste and its management is a big concern nowadays, and it is very problematic as far as other waste are concerned. Then the third category is recyclable waste. So this category contains the waste that the waste which we can recycle, or after recycling we can reuse. So recyclable waste comprises mostly plastic and e-waste. So there is one solution for plastic waste that we can recycle. That plastic waste, we can make some different things out of that plastic waste by recycling that material. And is another category of waste. The e-waste is generated from electronic devices or electronic gadgets of daily use, just like mobiles, and headphones, then computers, keyboards, mouse, desktop parts, then some TVs, LEDs. So all these are e-waste, and that e-waste is again it causes severe problem. It has it contains heavy metals. After dumping that e-waste at particular site, that heavy metals, they get leached at soil stream as well as water. water and creates serious problems. The heavy metals generated from that e-waste, they are highly carcinogenic, and proper waste management should be done in case of these two waste, so for example plastic waste as well as e-waste. So we can recycle these kind of two waste, and we can generate new things, and we can reuse the recycled goods, and we can make some different things out of that. Okay. So these are the three categories of waste. Now there is a solution for plastic waste, that eco-friendly packaging should be done, and it can be instead of using plastic, carrying cloth or cloth bags or metal fiber carry bags they should use. And nowadays, and it is many years, 4 to 5 years, people are much aware about the plastic waste, and they are using substitute for plastic bags, say for example cloth bags or natural bags. So the bags that are prepared from natural material, they are used. The next category of solid waste is comprises hospital waste, the waste that is generated from hospitals. You know that hospitals generated the waste, and that waste is again very problematic. It contains pathogens, and if that waste is not treated properly, again there are chances of spreading of diseases to that waste, and that hospital waste contains the disinfectant, then harmful chemical as well as carcinogenic microorganism, and generally it contains the dressings, remaining of dressings as well as cottons, as well as dressing material. Then waste that is generated during various operating processes, and the waste in case of needles, syringe, it contains pathogens, and that may lead to formation of it may lead to causing harmful diseases. So hospital waste is best to dispose the hospital waste by incinerator. So hospital waste generally it is incinerated. Now incineration is a process of direct burning. The waste that is collected from hospital is directly burned in furnace or in some other devices, and it is best to burn that waste because it kills all pathogens and all the harmful pathogenic agents. So it is best to treat the waste simply by burning, and the process of burning of that waste is known as incineration, and the instruments that are used for burning of the hospital waste, they are known as incinerators. Okay. E-waste, as I told you before, you can see in this picture there are dumping sites for these electronic gadgets, and after several days the heavy metals and other toxic metals from these dumping sites, they get leached. They mixed with water as well as mixed with soil, and they causes pollution of soil as well as water. And once if they get entered into the body of animals as well as plants as well as humans, they causes severe problem. In case of humans, they are highly carcinogenic, and nowadays e-waste is a big concern because the gadgets, they are say for example smartphones, mobiles, the use of these gadgets is increasing day by day, and the waste of these categories severely increasing day by day. Okay. So there are some novel solutions are given by some people. Say for example, in case of a plastic waste, one of the man known as Ahmed Khan, what he did, he used the plastic waste to make road, and he turned that plastic waste into some other form of material that is known as polyband, and that polyband is mixed with bitumen, and it is used in the formation of road. Okay. So these are the some novel initiatives taken by some people, and many of the government agencies, including government laboratories as well as some private companies, they are engaged in doing research in the area of plastic waste management, as well as waste management, and there are several success in few areas. Like this is the example of one of the conversion of plastic waste into road. This plastic waste that is that can be used in road or construction of road. The next kind of pollution that is caused by agrochemicals and fertilizers, it is again the area of serious concern. So you know that nowadays and since few decades we are performing our agriculture by using modern tools as well as techniques, and we call that agriculture as a modern agriculture. And fertilizers as well as pesticides, they are main part or unavoidable part of this modern agriculture. Without fertilizers, the yield of crops, agriculture crops, it cannot be significant or it cannot get increased. So as well as similarly in case of pesticides, to control various insect pests, pesticides are continuously used in agriculture field to increase the yield. If these two things they are not used, the yield will not be sufficient and there will be problem of food security. Okay, so use of agricultures and fertilizers in the past few decades is getting increased, and we cannot farmer cannot use other things or substitute for this category, because the yield will not be sufficient if you use alternatives. But these agrochemicals and fertilizers, they were very problematic as far as environmental point of view is concerned, because they causes pollution of air as well as pollution of water as well as pollution of soil. And the agrochemicals and fertilizers, they contain various organic chemicals. They are very toxic, and these toxic chemicals, they have very longer persistent time and they remain at longer period at an environment, and they are not easily get degraded by action of microbes, and they causes pollution of soil as well as water. And again, these agrochemicals and the fertilizers, the contents of these both, they are highly carcinogenic, and it causes various cancers, various types of cancers in case of humans, and their use is day by day increasing. So there are some substitute of for these two problems, that organic farming is the best substitute, that means use of avoiding the use of chemical fertilizer, and instead use of chemical fertilizer, the farming should be performed by using organic manures like compost and other things. And in case of agrochemicals, there are biopesticides. There are some of the biopesticides, they get developed, and use of biopesticides as well as some natural materials can be used as a to control the insect pest. Say for example, neem oil is there and other things is there. Okay, so ultimately to avoid the problem from agrochemicals as well as fertilizers, most of the farmers, they are adopting organic farming to avoid the problems from these two areas. And but the main drawback of adopting organic farming is that the yield is very short, means less, and it cannot possible to apply at larger scale. So there should be necessity to find other alternatives to these agrochemicals as well as fertilizers. So these are again of important concern as far as the environment is concerned, and these are highly burning issues nowadays to avoid use of agriculture pesticides as well as fertilizers. So integrated farming is one of the alternative to overcome these drawbacks of agrochemicals as well as chemical fertilizers. So integrated organic farming the synthetic fertilizers they are avoided, and instead of synthetic fertilizers of natural origin like compost or manure that are developed from cow dung and other sources, they are used. Instead of using chemical pesticides, biological pesticides they are used, and integrated pest management strategy is used to control insect pests, as well as various other tools and techniques that are eco-friendly and environmental friendly. They are utilized for performing this integrated organic farming. The next problematic waste is radioactive waste. So it is the waste that is generated from radioactive material. And few years ago, you might heard about the term tsunami. And in Japan, due to that tsunami, in the city of Fukushima, the nuclear reactor get burst, and it creates problem of emerging this radioactive waste. So radioactive waste is mostly generated from radioactive material, and it is highly carcinogenic. It creates genetic disorders among the persons who are influenced by this kind of waste, and these are really very problematic as far as human health and other point of view. So there should be proper management should be done for radioactive waste, and it should be handled very safely as far as health and safety is concerned. So nuclear radiation emerging from the radioactive waste, it causes mutation, and it leads to severe genetic disorders, and the genetic disorders may persist from one generation to next succeeding generation. Okay. So these are some pictures that are showing the reactors that are processing the radioactive energy or radioactive waste, and you can see in this picture it is recommended to store nuclear waste in their containers buried within the rock about 500 meters deep below the earth surface. Okay, but the public opposes this method, and these are some of the strategies that are used to manage that radioactive waste. The next again a very important area as far as environmental concern, that is greenhouse effect. So nowadays the temperature of earth has been increasing day by day or year by year by some considerable amount, and it is this is known as greenhouse effect, and that greenhouse effect is mostly caused by greenhouse gases. So greenhouse is a small glass house used for growing plants during winter, and the glass panel lets the light in but does not allow the heat to escape. So thus greenhouse warms up. So greenhouse it is generally used this term is used for developing nurseries, and it is used for agriculture crops. But the concept the main theme behind the greenhouse is that warming, the same warming is occurring in our earth, and that effect is known as greenhouse effect. So greenhouse effect is a natural phenomenon that occurs within of Earth's surface and atmosphere, and it maintains the present average temperature at 15 degrees Celsius. So without greenhouse effect, the average temperature of Earth at surface would have been -18 degrees Celsius, and increasing temperature is causing a severe problem of environment, and it is much problematic as far as environment is concerned, and it is highly concerned areas nowadays. The greenhouse effect leads to global warming. The average temperature of Earth is increasing year by year and day by day, and it's leading to causing melting of glaciers, then sea level rise, and it has several drawbacks as far as the ecosystem and environment is concerned. So it is very problematic as far as the environment and other things. So global warming is mostly caused due to greenhouse gases, and these greenhouse gases include carbon dioxide as well as methane as well as CFCs that are generated from freezing as well as the freeze rate, as well as nitrogen dioxide and the greenhouse gases, they form layer around the earth and they trap the reflected energy that is reflected from earth, and that layer of greenhouse gases creates warming of earth. So this particular effect is known as greenhouse effect, and due to that greenhouse effect the average temperature of earth is increasing year by year and day by day. So these are some of the terminologies. So for example, climate change, it is mostly popularly known as El Niño effect, and the El Niño effect is an abnormal weather pattern caused by warming of Pacific Ocean near to the equator and off the coast of South Africa. So it leads to melting of polar ice cap as well as in glaciers, and the melting of ice cap as well as glaciers, so it leads to rising of sea levels as well as some water body. So creating several problems, it is area of big concern to most of the countries as well as the state. There are some measures that we can use to control the effect of greenhouse gases as well as to prevent global warming. So we can reduce the use of fossil fuel, then we can improve energy efficiency, then we can reduce deforestation, and we can plant more and more trees to reduce the effect of greenhouse gases as well as global warming, and slowing down the growth of human population. These are some initiatives we can take to reduce the problem. So these are the details regarding some issues. In next lecture, we will continue with remaining issues.